All right, let's continue our discussion with Bagong Henerasyon Party List Representative Bernadette Herrera D. She's the principal author of the Anti-Hazing Law Act of 2018. Congresswoman D, good morning.
Hi, good morning, Karen, and good morning to all the viewers.
All right, is a review of the measure needed, or is culture the problem?
Well, it's not really the review of the bill kasi napakaganda na nung batas natin. It's really how the police should implement and the barangays, because I don't think the barangays are really doing their part in registering or waiting for the application or of initiations in one area. I think there has to be vigilance already in terms of implementation of this law.
But then how can the barangay actually know when a hazing initiation right will happen, when clearly students will keep this discreet?
Yes, but that's why normally you have to check what are the organizations under inside your barangay so that you know, because they're required to submit all members. They're required
but
to
but
submit.
But who's going to do that? That's what I mean. This is an Adamson University chapter.
Well, for schools.
Found in Imus, Cavite. So yes. If you're going to conduct hazing in Imus, you're not about to announce it to the barangay.
Well, but they are required to with the law.
I know. That's the point. But the point is, so in this sense, the law doesn't work. Because no one will register.
No, because there's a law existing, then they can be penalized because of that. Additional penalty for the organization and for the members of the organization as well. Okay. Officers, all those involved. So of course, if only this law will be implemented and then penalties will be extracted for those who are part of this, then the law would be working.
But is the law really the problem here, or frankly speaking, it is the culture of these fraternities? As Attorney Garbin said, it is embedded in Tau Gamma Phi. He said that on Head Start.
Yeah. Well, that's sad. That's really part of already the culture. That's why when you're passing this, we told them it's not because it's something that you're used to, it's right. So that's why we're banning it and we're making sure it won't happen again. But yeah, it's the culture is really different. Difficult. But other sororities and fraternities in universities are actually moving forward and doing online initiations, safe initiations. So it's possible. So I'm just really calling on again all fraternity members. If we want to welcome brotherhood, we shouldn't give 60 blows and wait for them to die. That's not already brotherhood.
But yeah, but should there be some kind of penalty to Tau Gamma Phi itself? I mean, the record of 41 deaths in the Philippines with hazing, 11 is under their fraternity.
Yes, there are penalties, especially if they did not follow the procedures in the law.
Oh, what are the penalties for a fraternity? Huh? Because what happens is when a crime happens, they isolate certain members. But then the fraternity is no longer answerable, you understand? What happens is the crime becomes personal. It is only the perpetrators. But then those students are also doing it under the culture of the fraternity. So I'm asking for a cultural change. How are fraternities answerable? Parang, let's say you're in a company, right? If the culture is sexual harassment is accepted, you don't just punish the person doing the harassment. You change the culture of the company.
Well, yeah, that's why here, all those present, all those who are part of planning, so it doesn't necessarily if you're present or not, if you're part of the planning, if you're a member of that organization and you're part of the planning, you'll be penalized as well. Those present and the school and the fraternity itself, if they did not follow the necessary rules set forth in the law, yung mismong fraternity pwedeng patawan din ng penalty.
Oo. In this case, for example, dapat bang patawan ng penalty ang fraternity?
Yes, especially it's supposed to have one representative every time there's initiation. So the first question is, did they give the school authority? So if there's no school authority present, then meaning they did not really police the initiation in their school. So it has to be a proactive role on their part to really make sure that fraternities follow the law.
Attorney, can you enumerate what kind of changes would you want to see since you believe that there's no need for the review in the law? How could the implementation of the law improve?
Well, it's really information dissemination to barangays. I don't think all barangays are really aware of this law yet. So I guess we'd have to do massive distribution of information dissemination. That's why I'm calling on DILG. It's about time that they do seminars on this. I hope it's another wake-up call for the police, the DILG, and the barangays, and the schools. Na because face-to-face na, this is again happening. Natahimik tayo for 2 years because of the pandemic, but because face-to-face classes already, then here we go again. And I think it's something that we should really be vigilant in facing and solving.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you, ma'am, for your time
thank
today. Bagong Generation Party's Representative Bernadette Herrera D. Thank you so much, Congresswoman.
Thank you.